Good afternoon, everyone. First of all, thank you for joining today's webinar. I'll be your host and trainer for the day, and my name is Manisha. So today we will be learning about inventory health tab, and we will also be sharing a couple of tips with you specifically for the upcoming Big Billion Day. So before we proceed further, I have actually ended up sharing a link with you. I'm sure that all of you should be able to see it. So over there, you can actually visit that link in order to know about each and every individual tab, starting with listing till growth, and learn more about it. So keep it handy with you. You never know specifically when you might require it to understand more things. So before we proceed further, a quick walkthrough about the tool that we are using today, just to let you know, we are using GoToWebinar tool, and you should be able to go ahead and see a questions tab on your control panel. In case of any queries or comments or any notification that you would like us to know, you can certainly go ahead and post your comments on this particular tab. You can open it, write on it, and then click send. That would help us get all the information that we need to know or your questions, and that would also help us in providing better training today. So today's webinar, roughly, if you look at the entire content, including the Q&A, it should not be more than 1.5 hours. However, our more focus would be on the question and answer session. Once we are done with the presentation, we would quickly move on to Q&A to ensure that all your queries have been resolved. I do understand that today's webinar is specifically related to inventory health, but in case if you post any queries and we are able to go ahead and provide you 100% or rather an accurate answer, we wouldn't hesitate to provide you that answer. So feel free to type in your comments. And if we cannot answer that, as I already mentioned, we would try to gather the answer for you and provide you a better resolution rather than, you know, beating around the bush. So before we begin, as I already said, we will also be enabling a couple of polls for you. So to begin with, I will be enabling the first poll just to understand if you were able to go ahead and see the presentation before the poll screen came up. Please keep that in mind that whenever such polls will be there on your screen, you will not be able to see the normal presentation window until and unless we close the poll from our end. So requesting your immediate response so that we can close the poll without any further delay. So that's pretty much it. That is how the poll would look like, and that is how our entire presentation and the webinar would work today. Feel free to type in your question. Like I said, please do not feel if you're thinking anything, you know, that might be silly or something that can be ignored, any such sort of question. Type in whatever you think. If you want me to keep it anonymous, feel free to let me know. I wouldn't announce the name. However, please ensure that ask every single question that you would like. So let's go ahead and begin. We are right on schedule. So today we will be learning about the inventory health tab. I'm sure that you all have seen it. Not sure how many of you have used it. However, today we will be learning about the entire tab and also talking about the different types of fulfillment and how to use that particular tab. Seller fulfillment and smart fulfillment both works in the same way almost. And apart from that, Flipkart fulfillment also we would be talking about. Before that, I would quickly like to know what is your fulfillment type. Please go ahead and respond to it. For the ones who does not know what exactly the rest of the fulfillment are, just to have a quick revision. Seller fulfillment is when you do the packing, you do all the work, the logistic team would come pick up your product and then deliver it to the customer. When we speak about smart fulfillment, it's more like you have a warehouse that has been designed as per Flipkart's standard, and it's optimized in a manner that you have to follow a set of standard. Lots of you know things are being involved over there. However, you do the packing with the help of you know the standard procedure that has been provided to you, and then the delivery guy comes and then picks up the product and then delivers it. Flipkart fulfillment, on the other hand, is where you go ahead and you send the product to Flipkart's warehouse. From there, we do the packing and delivery to the customer for you. So these are the three types of easy way of knowing fulfillment types, and to remember, that's the most important thing. So I can see a good number of people over here, and accordingly, we will go ahead and teach you how things work. Do not worry, I do understand there might be a lot of people who might actually go ahead and want to get into other fulfillment type. Do not worry, I'm sure that after BBD, you will have a lot of opportunity to get into it and ensure that your performance this festival, it speaks. That's the, you know, end result that you should be expecting as of now. So now let's proceed further. Let's go ahead and try to understand. Rather than taking you through this particular PPT, I would directly go ahead and prefer to show you directly from our dashboard, because that would make more sense. And let's have a quick look. So this is the inventory tab that we are looking at. You can look at it right now. And I would also like to know, how often do you actually end up using inventory tab? That means, you know, if you haven't ever opened it or you use it, please type in directly on the questions tab. If you're using something else to check your inventory or whatever method you are using to check your inventory, please go ahead and type in, because this is very, very important to know and understand your thoughts and your point of view. I'll be taking a few seconds over here, and then we will proceed further after we have the results of our poll. Thank you. Okay, thank you all for your response. It's great to see the diversity over here. And also at times it's sad because of the fact that we are looking at, you know, stop going ahead and looking at this tab once in a while. When I say once in a while, that is, you know, every Sunday, maybe once in a week or 15 days or a month. This is a tab that you actually need to go ahead and look at it every day, specifically this BBD, please guys. Because we all know that during this particular season, our sales, it grows 6 times more than the normal seasonal growth that we have seen. Because of which, ensure that every day before you wrap up, you know, before you go to sleep, go ahead and have a look at it. It'll just take hardly a minute. You can do the same thing while, you know, before you go to your bed and sleep, or while you're watching news or whatever you want to do. Please invest at least a minute of your time over here. I'll tell you what exactly it looks like and how it works, so that things would become more and more easier for you, and accordingly it will become, you know, a habit of yours. It's great to know that we have among us people who are actually doing the basic hygiene check every day. So overall, if I put it across, this particular tab, that is the inventory held dashboard, would help you in knowing that how many stock, what is your stock count currently. We have got a lot of questions where, you know, people have ended up asking that our listings tab used to have the low stock filter earlier. So now that low stock has been moved to inventory tab, that would give you an overview of what is the status of your inventory and how many listings are actually out of stock. And all this information have been, you know, synchronized under one tab to make things easy for you. So let's go ahead and look at it. So I'll be starting with seller fulfillment and smart. It's pretty much the same. So select the fulfillment type. This is how the tab looks like. Over here, you can see your product information. For seller fulfillment, the easiest part is you can easily go ahead and make changes to the stock count over here directly. Similarly, to be on the safer side, you can actually go ahead and choose the sale count over here. For example, this will give you a calculation that within the last 7 days, on an average, what was your daily sales? Based on that, this particular days on hand will be calculated. That simply shows that this particular stock count would last for how many days. So this will give you a vivid example and accordingly help you in taking advantage and control over your stock. So this is a test account. That's the only reason you might not be able to go ahead and see it. It might end up showing you undefined if you had zero sales, to be very honest. But however, I'm sure that no one is on that page today. So this would be a very good example of understanding your average sales daily for 7 days or for 14, 30, 60 or 90 as per your choice. And if you update it till 50, for example, how many days will it last? As we all know that BBD is for 5 days and it is the most crucial moment, you'll get back-to-back sales. So this is the most important thing for you to do, is to calculate accordingly so that you are not left with unnecessary inventory by the end of the day. So apart from that, you can always go ahead and use filters like categories and brand. Also, you can go ahead and download the stock file and update it accordingly. So this also makes things easier for you. Moving on to the low stock will tell you, for example, you can see all the products which have less than 14 days of the inventory. For example, if you want to go ahead and check that for how many days will that product last. For example, if you look back at all inventory, we have this days on hand, right? So it gives us a number of days that the product would last for. So if you want, you can change it. For example, you can make it 10. So I want to see all the products under low stock that would last only for 10 days, right? And that would be over after 10 days. So that would actually give you a control and give you time. That is the most important thing, to prepare and to refill your stock accordingly so that you can take quick actions rather than panicking later down the line. Similarly, for out of stock also, you will be able to go ahead and understand that as you do not have that particular stock with you, what is your potential money that you have lost just because you don't have that particular stock with you. So this will give you an overview level of all the information that is good to know for a businessman, because you will not only have a control over your profit, but also you will end up knowing that what is the loss that you might incur. Apart from that, you have other important information, like if you're speaking about Smart, it's the same report that you can see over here. However, for Smart fulfillment, you can always go ahead, choose your product and invert from here itself. Similarly, you can recall your product. You can see, you can invert, plus you can recall your products. So that makes your work easier from this page directly. Knowing the stock, if you can see that, you can change the days on hand over here, the number of days. You can invert your products looking at the numbers that would require immediate action. Similarly, you can invert your products for the out of stock. So quick action, and accordingly, you will get to know that what is the most important product that requires your immediate action. Similarly, when we speak about Flipkart fulfillment, over here, clicking on, it's almost the same thing. However, you will have the create bulk consignment option over here. By using the stock file, you can create the consignment. Similarly, you can recall the same from this window itself. Apart from that, you will have one more that is called the aging tab. Aging tab would actually help you in understanding to know the products which are the inventory which are older than 90 days. So this will actually help you in understanding, you know, the fee that you are ending up paying and the quantity, the ones which will soon become the products which are older than 90 days or the old stock. So this will actually help you in understanding the money that you might end losing up, and accordingly take actions for your recall to recall listing. So knowing all this under one tab actually makes your things easier, because along with that, you also can check for each and every warehouse what is the status. So now, from listing earlier, if you look at it, listing management page, we do understand that a couple of things have been changed over here, but things have been now kept in such a synchronized or such an organized manner that you can actually not only look at it and not take action, but take quick actions over here rather than, you know, being delayed. So make it a habit, guys, that you check every single day this particular page without further delay to understand what is the status of your business and what would be your upcoming sales. Obviously, we have the most important season coming, and it is very, very important for us to know at the tip of our fingers how is it going or what is happening. So this page would help you not only know the status, but also will help you in taking full control of your business. Then coming back to our PPT, before we have a quick revision and check, start with our Q&A. Like I said, we'll focus more on Q&A. So that was more about the inventory tab, but let's look at some tips over here. Few things that we would be focusing on are, you should have ample amount of inventory for the festive season. Keep your inventory stocked, please. You never know what order you might get, and keep it stocked rather than panicking towards the end. Keep track of in-demand product. So guys, please ensure that you know what is the current trend. If you go to Selection Insights, this page would help you in understanding the products which are a trend right now and accordingly take actions. You can also see that currently in mobiles and accessories category, Redmi 6 Pro is in demand. 6 lakh people in Flipkart.com has actually searched for this particular product. Accordingly, in product trend, you can see the 7 sellers have started selling from this particular product and above, and the 7 sellers that we are talking about are the best sellers. And also it will help you in understanding the trending products. Like you can see Mami Poco, it's trending right now and it's new. Similarly, the massage oil for babies and all. And this is the normal interest graph that you're going ahead and seeing over here. So know what is your in-demand product. For FBF, that is Flipkart Fulfillment, ensure that 40% of your consignment quantity should be from the recommended products in order to avoid consignment cancellation. So this is something that our Flipkart Fulfillment sellers should know and understand, that ensure that 40% of your consignment quantity should be from the recommended products in order to avoid consignment cancellation. And for Smart, ensure that you fulfill 50% of your orders from Smart Fulfillment. So these are a few of the tips that we would like to go ahead and share accordingly. These are a few things that you should keep in mind whenever you go ahead and work your hands on. So sellers, I'll be taking 5 minutes of your time right now. We will start our Q&A in another 5 minutes. You can start typing your questions directly. This was more or less about the entire inventory tab. We wrapped up the presentation sooner than we thought. We'll start with our Q&A. You can start posting the question. Meanwhile, if you want, please try your hands on the inventory tab. Take your time to ask your question. I'll be with you to answer all the questions. So please do not panic. You can ask any question. Thank you. Couple of polls will be there on your screen requesting you to kindly respond. We have a special guest with us. He would actually go ahead and like us to learn more about the upcoming Big Billion Day and how to go ahead and prepare about the same thing. So let's hear it from him and understand how we would go ahead and look at it. So sellers, I'm also looking at your questions. Do not worry. We would certainly go ahead and take all the questions. We are looking at it. I have received questions from Devagya, Ritu Shah, Manish Kumar. So definitely we will go ahead and answer. So kindly give us a minute over here. Thank you.
Hello. Hi guys, this is Apoor Verma here. I'm from the seller marketing team. And today I'll take a couple of minutes to, answer some of the most frequently asked questions to the Flipkart seller team. We had crowdsourced a few questions from you guys a couple of weeks back. We had, we had done an event where we had answered few of them. I would like to read out the questions to you guys and also give you a brief overview of the answers. And I hope this will be very helpful for you guys in the festive season, as well as, in improving your overall business on Flipkart in the long run. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to read out the question first, which was asked. I will also say tell the name of the person who's asked it. So this is Jatin, who had asked us, what role does keyword play in the visibility of a product? And what is the maximum limit for a keyword for a single FSN? So I guess a lot of you might be using, Flipkart advertisements, and even without that, keywords would be one of the most important things that are used to display your product, because as and when a buyer comes on our site, if he's not really sure exactly of what he's supposed to purchase, it's the keywords that he's going to use, and therefore it is one of the most important pointers while listing your product on any e-commerce site. About the maximum limit of keywords, there is currently no limit on the number of keywords that you can have for your FSN. You can have a big keyword as well, but generally you should keep in mind and make a keyword put a keyword which would be very frequently used by the buyer. So you have to understand that sentiment
Just to add on over here, guys, when we speak about keywords, specifically during Flipkart advertising, you cannot go ahead and add keywords that you would like your customers to look out for. You can only go ahead and exclude the keywords that you wouldn't go ahead and like to show that advertisement for. Similarly, when you speak about listings have total limitation of 1024 keywords. You can go ahead and look for search keywords option in the additional column during single listing process. Similarly, you can scroll your mouse towards the end where you see the green color boxes or green color column in your bulk template. You'll be able to go ahead and find description, key features, and search keywords. Over there also, you can go ahead and type in your keywords separated by a comma. But please keep in mind, during listing process, only the first three keywords will be taken under consideration for Flipkart, and it should be relevant to your topic. So if you're going ahead and listing something that is not matching the keyword, then QC might remove it. So please know the difference over here.
Sure. Thanks, Manisha, for the information as well. Okay. So Vishal asks, when will you enable thermal label printing? So we have been working on it. It's a work in progress, still not been made live. If any of you guys are on smart fulfillment, probably you should see thermal label printing available by this month end. And probably by the year end, this capability should also be available to all the sellers. That's about thermal label printing. So Rising India, this is one of the sellers who has asked us, what is your step to avoid order fraud from buyers if the same thing is happening from a particular location? So, well, if you are facing such a case where you're getting repeated fraud orders from a particular buyer, you need to report it to seller support. And we also keep proactively checking your Facebook posts to figure out if there are any such issues. So do let us know through any of the channels. Apart from that, we do internal analysis. We proactively observe trends and always take corrective action if we suspect a fraud. In case we are certain that it's a fraud case, we will blacklist the buyer from Flipkart. That is what we are doing currently on this. Okay, so moving on, so another question is from Sandeep. He says, this is about advertising. He says, I have limited access to advertising. How can I increase my advertising? Just to keep the perspective clear, it's a very simple problem. Everyone has equal access to whatever is available on the dashboard. There is no discrimination basis any of the parameters. So everyone will have equal access to advertising, and you can increase your advertising for the FSN you have listed by, you know, going ahead with the normal advertising process. There's no difference as such. So that's one of the things. Okay, so Jatin, there's another question from Jatin. He had asked us, a lot of stress is put on product rating, but there is no option to download the data from the seller panel, and it becomes very difficult to analyze the product rating, and how can you dispute wrong product ratings? So right now we do not have a bulk option of displaying all your product ratings on one page, but FSN level product ratings are available. You will get an option to see bulk ratings as well in the coming future. We are working towards the revamping the detail page. And currently this is all system run. You can always raise it to seller support about the wrong product ratings that are coming across, and we can have a look at it. But again, there is no such way as such. Okay, so I'll answer a couple more. These are all questions, of course, that you guys have asked to us. So Vishal again asks, corrugated boxes are very expensive and it is very tough competition and there are high courier returns. So what is your solution towards it? So again, this is something which is a work in progress. We are coming with a product to suggest the best packaging material basis of product and dimensions, and it will help you optimize the packaging option. Again, you should be hearing about this by the end of this year. Currently we have, if you guys are aware, you guys should be aware is that we have launched festive packaging, so that will distinguish your boxes. It will from the usual Flipkart packaging material. It will give a good flavor of the festive season to the sellers, to the buyers as well, and it should really help in getting getting good feedback from about your products as well. I'll do one more question. So Romil Jan asks, why Flipkart has such strict MRP sticker guidelines for Flipkart Assured? Flipkart is asking for a lot more details in the barcode sticker than that is required. A lot of details are required, there are products which are getting rejected. So again, to answer Romil's question, this is not something that Flipkart has thought of on its own. This is a legal metrology norm which the government has defined. So there have been instances in the past that where the government has been very strict in not even allowing very minor variations. So what happens is if there are minor variations and the product gets rejected, we do not want any sellers to get their stock seized, and therefore we are asking for such strict, we are also following such strict norms. Be very aware about legal metrology norms. These are very crucial. Therefore, and F assured is not related, just to clear it out, F assured is not at all related to the legal metrology norms. These are the norms which have been defined by the government. They are not related, and they have to be followed by us as a company as well as all of you guys. Sure. So I'll hand it back to Manisha now. Thank you. And also, I'll wish you a very happy BBD. All the best for that. Have great sales. Have great sales and have a great month ahead. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Apurva. So sellers, let's start. I'm sure that you might have a lot of upcoming questions related to the commonly or frequently asked question. So let's start. First question we'll be taking is from Ritu Shah. Business ka big ticket upcoming sale, how to participate in that? So sellers, you all will have an opportunity to opt into the BBD sales. You can go to Flipkart, you can go to promotions, all the Flipkart promotions over there. You should be able to opt in starting today. So I guess that answers your question. Ritu again asked a question, that is how to join Smart Fulfillment and Flipkart Fulfillment. So currently, as we are not, now everything is paused as of today, as we are talking about specifically for the upcoming BBD. However, later down the line, based on your performance, you can go ahead and send in a request to seller support depending on your per day sales. And there are several other eligibility criteria. If you meet it, definitely, why not? You can go ahead and be a part of it. How to track best selling products? Manish Kumar, you can go to Selection Insight. Like I said, go to listings. The last option will be Selection Insight. You should be able to go ahead and do that. Okay, Devagya Goyal, one of your question, that is, you would like to sell the branded products like Tide Surf. So what to do in this case? You can either provide a dealer's invoice or a brand authorization letter while going ahead and trying to list it and get the brand approval. You can go ahead and start selling the same. Just a minute here. Devagya, please requesting you to get in touch with seller support and request assistance on grocery, because dry fruits, it comes under grocery. So they should be able to help you, as you already have the FSSAI license. I think that's great. So this will make your work soon, actually. So just a minute. Ritu, to answer your question, what is luxury cess in listing? Just to let you know, this is a type of cess that is levied only on the luxury items, so you can look at it. Okay, looking at more question, can you describe the keyword? Like it's one of the keyword that can be. Mahmood Sheikh, sir, we will go ahead and post, you know, the webinars that has happened related to or the BBD specifically, starting with listing and then payments and all the topics on SLC. Don't worry about it. You'll be able to understand more about the keywords thing. We wouldn't be talking much about the keyword section because we do not have an expert with us today who would give you a better visibility. However, keyword is something that it acts like a search keyword, that if your customers type that keyword, they can look at it. Go ahead and try to enter 3 at a time. That would help you. Chandrani, I got your issue that you said that why is this happening every time when I try to re-upload images. So Chandrani, it might happen that, you know, QC removes or rejects the listing that is incorrect or that is not relevant to the product description. So they might have removed that particular photo that you might have put in for it being not properly synced. So requesting you to kindly raise an SS ticket as soon as possible. If you have an FSN number, for example, that would be great, and that should actually help you. Tushar, you can go ahead and click on the 3 dots that you see towards the top right-hand side corner. The second option will be contact seller support. You'll have to go over there and click on ask assistance, and that is how you'll be able to do it. Just a minute, Ritu, let me give you a better explanation of luxury SIS. Just a minute. Like I said, it is one sort of, like we had Aam Aadmi, there was one Swachh Bharat Abhiyan tax, something like that. Let me quickly tell you exactly what it is. So it's it's about the GST Council. It's a hike on luxury specifically, and it's related to the tax that is levied on the luxury items. So you can go ahead, Google about it more. I'm sure that you will have a better idea. You'll have a lot of articles coming in. Okay, Kuor Singh, nice. Actually, a very nice question that you have come across, let us know about. That is, you know, how to go ahead and provide additional discounts from your end. So in that case, you can definitely go ahead and create your own promotions. If you go to growth, you will be able to see my promotions option. You can go ahead and create your own promotions where you can design a discount that you would like your customers to see and select the discounts for a particular listing or the types of listing that you would like to go ahead and see for that particular thing. Devagya Goel, if you're a new seller, you can go ahead and try to register it. However, currently registration, the onboarding is paused because of the ongoing season. So you can definitely go ahead and wait for BBD to be over, then you can go ahead and update your GSTN number. If you are a new seller, you can definitely go ahead and get in touch with our SS, give them the updated number, and that should be done. Manish, can you please rephrase your question when you ask, can we put products in advertisement permanent in front of Flipkart? This is not pretty clear. So if you can elaborate it. Tushar, like I said, you can go ahead, click on ask assistance, and then type in all your questions. I'm sure they should be able to help you. If I'm of any use today, you can start typing your questions over here. I'll try to answer as much as I can. So I see a lot of questions coming in related to listing. So let me do one thing. Once we are done with the webinar, I will be sending you the entire recording of this current webinar, and I'll ensure that I add in the recording of listings webinar and Flipkart advertising webinar also, so that you get to know more. If you have missed it, at least you'll learn more about it. While we wait, keep taking more questions. I've raised the poll. That is the last poll for today's evening to understand how would you rate the webinar so far, requesting your response. Meanwhile, we will start taking your question. Manish, when you say how to take approval of the product, if you can be more specific, what product are you talking about and what approval are you asking for, that would be great. Chandrani, to be very honest, the best part is opt into as many promotions as possible, but ensure you go ahead and check if a listing is not opted into multiple products, because of which you might end up incurring loss. Use the include exclude feature, that is, you know, check all the listings. If something is actually giving you less money in return, go ahead and exclude that listing from that particular promotion. So you can take your decisions accordingly, and that should do the job. Ritu, like I said, you can opt in to Flipkart promotions. That is already a promotion specifically designed from the BBD perspective. Opt in to as many promotions as you want, one at a time, because in bulk, you wouldn't be able to go ahead and access a bulk file with all the promotions. So go ahead and please check whatever suits you. Start doing it one at a time. Mehmood, if you ask me, specifically the best steps which are helpful in reaching from silver status to bronze. The first thing is we should be aware that this November, that is after a month, you know, the tiering would happen again. So this particular season, BBD is the best example and the best opportunity for you to go ahead and reach that threshold. Like for bronze, from bronze to be a silver, you'll have to go ahead and meet, you know, either the GMV value or the units that you need to sell apart from rest of the thing. Meeting rest of the things are easy as compared to the money that you need to meet or as compared to the units that you need to sell. So this BBD will give you a very good example and rather set a very good example for yourself and give you an opportunity to go ahead and get as much as sales as possible. Last year, if you look at the data, 3,000 sellers, rather more than that, actually just ended up exceeding their sales in just those 5 days. And they have touched, within 5 days, they ended up earning more than 10 lakh. So you can imagine how easy it becomes for you in order to earn that much money within this 5 days. So please go ahead and make the best out of it. Okay, Manish, for the products like MAC or any other thing, the brand authorization letter would be required most probably. Yeah, it would be required. It is necessary. So you will have to contact the regional office of that particular brand and get the brand authorization letter from them. Also, they should mention that you are authorized to sell it online, because brand authorization letter differs if it's, you know, offline, that is you open a MAC showroom or a normal thing. So you can go ahead and get the document. Chandrani, if you can give, you know, a specific error that you might have come across, that would be great. Sellers, we also have Ankita with us who would help us in understanding more, and she's the expert of today's session. So Ankita, we have a question from Chandrani. She's asking, what is the matter of FSP change that leads to block her listing? Uh, Hi Chandrani, it's Ankita this side. So when you talk about FSP change, so it's nothing but the Flipkart selling price. So we have observed in past that what happens sometimes, you know, some people change the price of their product, price of their listing, which is closer to the sale, so that they can, with the intention of providing more or better discounts or good discounts to the customers. But which in turn lead to a negative experience from a customer's angle, because a customer is very intelligent, you know, these days. They can compare the prices before and now, and hence they take a decision for purchasing a product. So to maintain a standard customer experience on the platform, we advise you not to change the Flipkart selling price before the sales. So we monitor last 30 days ka FSP that you have for your product, and then we come up to an average price, which is like, you know, your product should be within that particular price range only. So that is what FSP freezes, that you should not change the selling price of your product closer to the sale dates. I hope that answers your questions.
So I have another important question that is related to can we use biodegradable packaging as government has banned plastic by Manish. Manish, communication has already been sent out to everyone. Flipkart has launched a particular security bags and plastic packaging that follows the CPCB guidelines. So let me share the link with you so that you can go ahead and purchase all the packaging materials from there. Please do not use any further packaging materials, because you never know when your consignment might get rejected. So Ritu, to answer your question, how to add product weight in grams. So whenever you are entering the weight of the product, it will give you an option to go ahead and choose the metric that you would like to choose. So you can go ahead and try that. Core, if I understand that, as per your question, whom to approach in order to provide you for brand authorization letter directly to the wholesaler or the company. See, if we are talking about brands like MAC, this is a huge brand. If you do not go ahead and take the letters from the company, there are chances that they might end up suing you. So to be on the safer side, it is always better. Okay, guys, we can see a lot more questions coming in. Why sometimes listing is inactive for no reason? So, Mehmood, when you speak about listing being inactive or archived, that is where you take the action. If it's in block status, that is where Flipkart takes action on your product. So, if it's inactive, there might be a chance that it has been done by mistake from your end. So, please look at it. Manisha, what we do to make sales status bronze to gold? The first thing, like I said, please go ahead and see. Because see, from becoming a gold seller directly, it's a pretty hard task. However, you need to ensure that you meet the target that has been given to you, right? The threshold. Once you meet it for all the metrics, I'm sure that you'll be able to go ahead and do it. Ritu, amazing question. Thank you. I was waiting for this question to come in, but couldn't see much. That is how to increase your sales. Ritu, to be very honest, it's not only you know, a question from your end, but it's for everyone. So guys, it is very, very important for you all to understand the importance, know the demand of the market and accordingly supply the product. Do not just assume that you have a product, it will automatically get sold out. No, it's a big no-no. Understand the market that you all are dealing with. Check that if you're selling an Ayurvedic product in your category, which is the trending one, the price, everything matters. Opt into as many promotions, because our customers, they are very, very smart and they know that, you know, BBD is coming, they'll go ahead and purchase. They're waiting for it, right? We have Navratra after BBD. You can imagine the craziness. So go ahead and opt in logically. Do not just opt in randomly. Think, process, and then opt in. Use advertising and promotions hand in hand, and accordingly take your decisions. Do not just rush. And as and when someone once told me this, do not take your customers' rating lightly. Opt in to as much as promotions as possible after knowing what are you getting into. This would always help you in giving more and more offers to your customers. Remember, BBD is an offer, not something that you go ahead and you just imagine someone coming into. When I talk about Flipkart advertising, this is, your products have been advertised on Flipkart, right? So every action, that is every time a customer comes and click on that particular product, they see the ad and all. So this are being paid in credit. I'll be sharing all the recordings with you. I'm sure that you'll learn more about it and accordingly take actions. So I don't see much questions coming in related to our inventory. We will be wrapping up the session over here today. Do not worry, in case if you have more questions, you can always reach out to us. And specifically during this BBD, we are there to help you. And also we'll be sharing all the recordings so that you learn more about it and accordingly take actions. Thank you so much. We have our next webinar tomorrow about orders. Please be a part of it and learn more about orders. I'm sure that you would love it. And have a great day ahead and best of luck for this upcoming BBD. Thank you so much. And I'm sorry if I couldn't answer your question. Please don't get disheartened. We'll come back again tomorrow with new topic. And I'm sure that we'll be able to help you further. Take care. Happy selling.